Let's come to question number 5. The question number 5 says a torque of 10 Newton meters is transmitted through a stepped shaft. The torsional stiffness of sections MN and O and OP are 20 Newtons meter per radians, 30 and then 60 respectively. So this is the shaft which is shown to you. It's a stepped shaft. You can say that this shaft and this shaft, or these three sections are joined in series. Okay. So for a series shaft, we need to find out the angular deflection between ends M and P of the shaft. So between this and this. Okay. So in a nutshell, I need to find out theta 1, theta 2, and then theta 3. The torsional stiffness for this is 20, this is 30, and this is 60. Okay, so what is theta for the compounded shaft? Is theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. So what is theta 1 equal to? Theta 1 is equal to the torque upon the torsional stiffness for the first section plus torque upon the torsional stiffness for the second section plus torque upon the torsional stiffness for the third section. So torque is 10 throughout. This would be 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30 plus 1 by 60. So you will have 1 radians as the answer. So when you solve this, you get 1 radian. Okay. So the option, or the correct option, is B, which is 1 radian. Okay. So I hope you understood this question. A very simple question. Just look at that. This is a shaft in series. Okay. And you are required to find out the deflection between point M and P. So this means you need to find out the sum of these three deflections. And for a series arrangement, this is the formula. Okay, because the torque transmission will be same throughout, you will have different angular deflections. So I hope you understood this question number 5. Now let's move on to question number 6.